We have scenes in the movie where we are showing the development of Jigsaw's traps.
John Kramer, before he has his transformation into Jigsaw, tests subjects. He sketches his first trap, which becomes the Cecil trap, the chair trap, we called it.
He's gonna pull out the thing of knives. He's gonna walk behind you, put them on, put the knives on, so it's more of a reveal. You just give me random, like, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you doing this to me?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Cecil has to lean forward into this device. As he leans forward, of course, he's gonna slice his face and eventually hit a little plate that will release his wrists and ankles.
Once you hit your extreme wide, you can slowly start pushing back in, guys.
Okay.
So once you hit your wide, hold it for a beat, and really try to focus on his wrist bleeding.
What we did for that was a lot of bleeding prosthetics, the old bladder underneath the prosthetic for his wrists being cut up.
Good line you can give me here, which is just, please, I'm fucking bleeding. I can put that anywhere.
The effects guys provided the bleeding knives for his face when he pushes his face through the knives.
But the trap doesn't work. It breaks halfway through, and Cecil gets out.
And then I charge him, and I fall into a Twisted Pictures logo.
The razor wire, of course, gives Jigsaw the idea for a trap that we see later on in time and so on.
This is significant because it shows that transformation between John Kramer and Jigsaw, the serial killer.
I want to play a game.